let's talk about the predictions made by activists, including the IPCC, and compare them with the actual data. In the 1970s, we were told, and many of you will remember this, that we're heading for another ice age, right?
What scientists are telling us now is that the threat of an ice age is not as remote as they once thought.
At weather stations in the far north, temperatures have been dropping for 30 years. Sea coasts, long free of summer ice, are now blocked year-round. According to some climatologists, within a lifetime, we might be living in the next ice age.
Now, that didn't happen.
No.
Oops. But some of the same experts who predicted global cooling started talking about global warming. But then again, those predictions didn't materialize. So today, it's just called climate change. Right. Right? It's just climate change.
Yeah. For example, 2008, Dr. Tim Flannery from the Australian government's climate change unit said, just imagine yourself in a world 5 years from now. So that would be 2013.
2013.
Yeah. When there's no more ice over the Arctic.
Oh.
In that same year, Al Gore made a similar prediction. That was the common view of the mainstream climate scientists at the time. Now, the minimum annual coverage of Arctic sea ice has declined from a high of about 7.5 million square kilometers in 1990. But it was actually higher in 2020 than it was in 2012, at nearly 4 million square kilometers.
And that's a lot of ice.
That's still a lot of ice.
So the predictions were way off.
Yeah.
And by the way, the fluctuations in the amount of Arctic ice over time are expected. This was especially true after the post-flood ice age a few thousand years ago. Right.